Hey guys, it's Dave from AFE Power. So today we're going to do a cool little do-it-yourself project. We're going to put a new fuel filter on my 2022 GMC 3.0 diesel. It's a simple fix, something you can do on your own, do with your kids, and save a lot of money. We'll walk you right through it. Okay, so continuing with our fuel filter, you'll notice I jacked the truck up and put a jack stand underneath the frame. The fuel filter is located on the driver's side, that's the left side, on the frame rail, on the side of the car, like this. We need two tools, a T40 Torx wrench to get to the bottom right there, and that's just a drain. And this is actually a 36 millimeter to unscrew the housing. So these are on there with about 14 pounds of torque. It's a 36 millimeter socket. This happens to be a 1-inch drive, but I have it from my Volkswagen tools. So we're gonna retorque that when we get done, but we're just gonna take it all apart right now. You see the gasket? And a beautiful diesel fuel. So one thing, we wanna make sure that there's no dirt. We got a little carb cleaner. We're gonna clean out the housing and the inside. One thing we're gonna do, this little blue O-ring, we're gonna change that out. And AFE actually gives us a new O-ring. So continuing on, you can see the old filter. Definitely time to replace it. It's got an O-ring on the top and an O-ring in the side. The new AFE one actually has an O-ring on the side and an O-ring in the top. So we don't need to do that. You can tell the difference. Now, the O-ring on the inlet that we replaced and this one on the housing, AFE's gonna give that to us and we're gonna replace those out and make sure we do that, okay? So we put a little fuel on the O-ring. We're gonna set it back down in the clean canister. It goes to the small end in first and it'll click just like that. Now we can install it back in the car. So we have the new O-ring that AFE supplied us on the pickup. We have the new filter and both O-rings applied. When this filter's tight, you shouldn't be able to see this O-ring right there. And this little gap should be totally closed down. So we got a little ways to go. And then we put 14 pounds of torque on this 36 millimeter nut. So that's it, pretty simple. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn the key on, keyless ignition, hold it down without the brake. That turns on the fuel pump and we're gonna let that cycle. We can hear it pumping. GM says to do this for 2 minutes. So what that does is it primes the system, gets any air out of the system. Shouldn't be any drivability issues with that. While we're doing that, we gotta remember to go ahead and fix the service filter on the dash that's done as well. Pretty simple project. So today we used a 44 FF023 AFE ProGuard fuel filter. That's gonna fit a 20 to 25, all the GMs and all the Silverado Chevy 3.0s. It also fits the 17 to 25 6.6s. One of the things I always like to do is redo a little bit of my fuel treatment booster. And this one little bottle will do 100 gallons. There's about a quarter left. It's real simple. You stick it in and that's it. Great little side project for father, son, teach your kids, do it yourself, save some money. And problems or questions, give us a call. AFE Power, AFE Dave here.